all week we've been talking about preparedness, preparedness, preparedness. Get your kit in order, get situated. But now, as watches start to be posted for portions of the Florida coastline, we're now in the action phase. We now need people to start taking action. Some evacuation orders have been ordered by emergency officials in the impacted area, and there's more to come, probably later today. And I want to stress that if you're ordered to evacuate, that you must comply with those evacuation instructions. So many times we see people second guess emergency managers and evacuation instructions, and it often costs them dearly. The portion of the coastline that is expected to be impacted, there's two things that concern me. First and foremost, it hasn't had a major hurricane impact in a long, long time. So we have a lot of coastal residents that probably don't have a ton of experience with major hurricanes. Also, this portion of the coastline, the west coast of Florida, is incredibly vulnerable to storm surge, very, very vulnerable to storm surge. And this is the quintessential case of not focusing on the exact track, because we won't have to have the track make or the center make a direct hit for there to be significant storm surge along the Florida west coast. We're indicating the potential for as much as 10 feet of storm surge in portions of the Florida west coast. If you need a reference to what 10 feet of storm surge looks like, this pole here, that would be about to the top of that pole to give you a reference of what it could look like. And this pole is colorized to reflect our forecast products so that you can get a sense of what those forecasts mean from a perspective. I just again want to stress that if you've been ordered to evacuate, it's very, very important that you follow those instructions from local emergency managers. Thank you.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. It's really great to be here today. I'm Deanne Criswell, the FEMA administrator. And, you know, I'd like to just start out by thanking President Biden for quickly approving the emergency declaration just hours after Governor DeSantis had requested the emergency declaration. And I think, as you saw earlier today, we've added more counties into that emergency declaration. What that declaration does is it gives the governor and his team the ability to get reimbursed for a lot of the costs that they're incurring right now to make sure that they are ready to support residents for this storm. And it also gives FEMA the ability to continue to move resources into the area and stage resources to support the immediate response needs after the storm passes. As you heard from Jamie, Hurricane Ian is projected to have significant impacts across Florida. And the path of the storm, I don't want people to get necessarily focused on just the direct path and the direct impact of the storm. We are going to see some direct impacts along the west coast of Florida and into the Panhandle. But everybody in Florida is going to have potential impacts from this storm. What we are seeing from a lot of the storms, a lot of the hurricanes that we have experienced over the last year, is significant amount of rain, and this storm is no different. It's going to bring a significant amount of rain, which means that people inland are going to be subject to inland flooding. And so it's really important that everybody listen closely to what your local officials are telling you to do. I think, as you have heard from Governor DeSantis, as well as his director, Kevin Guthrie, that the threats from this storm, they are significant. They are serious. And so, again, listen to your local officials. If they ask you to evacuate, listen to them. And what you can do now is make sure that you know where you're going to evacuate to, you know how you're going to communicate with your family members to let them know that you're safe, and make sure that you're putting together all of your important documents that you might need. But also, you may be asked to shelter in place. You may be asked to stay where you're at. And if you are asked to stay where you're at, make sure that you have the supplies that you need to support yourself for a few days. I would say that everybody that's in the path or even on the edge of the path of this storm should expect to see power outages. I think I heard Governor DeSantis say that earlier today. So make sure that you're charging all of your cell phones right now and you're making copies of important documents. You're going to need those after the storm passes. We are also at FEMA monitoring the potential impacts of the states north of Florida. So once it leaves Florida, what those impacts might be in Georgia and South Carolina. And I'll be reaching out to the governors there as we get more information. In terms of some of the FEMA support that's going on right now, we have sent a really strong team of emergency managers that are embedded in with the state office in Tallahassee. We've sent urban search and rescue teams to be pre-staged to really complement the really incredible capability that Florida already has. We have commodities that are located across the United States. We are pre-positioning some of them closer to Florida, so we'll be able to move those in very quickly if needed once the storm passes. And yesterday we activated our Regional Response Coordination Center in FEMA Region 4, and we activated our National Response Coordination Center at headquarters. This allows us to bring our full federal family together in one place to make sure that we can coordinate all of the needs and the requests that come from the state. So what I can say is that the federal government, we are ready to support Florida's efforts. And my message to everybody listening today is this. Make sure that you do not underestimate the impacts of this storm. I also have concerns, as Jamie mentioned, about the fact that this part of the state has not experienced a hurricane in nearly 100 years, but I also worry about individuals that have moved to the area that have never experienced a hurricane. And so we want to make sure that they are heeding the advice of their local officials. Some of the steps that you can take right now is make sure that you're signing up for emergency alerts. Know how you're going to get information. You can sign up for local emergency alerts in the counties and the cities where you live. You can sign up for the FEMA app that will also give you real-time weather alerts. Getting information and knowing how you're going to get information is incredibly important. Again, if you're asked to evacuate, know where you're going to go. Know what the route is that you're going to take and what it is that you're going to need to take with you. If you have pets, don't forget to bring supplies for your pets as you evacuate. And again, if you're asked to shelter in place, make sure that you have the supplies you need to support yourself. I'd also like to say that we know that there's many individuals that perhaps have access and functional needs. And so making sure that you are taking the extra steps to know what it is that you're going to need to do and reaching out to your local officials to understand what resources that they have available to you. It's my understanding that Florida does have some assistance available to help people evacuate if they need assistance. And so making sure that you're taking those steps right now. And then the last thing I also always like to say, and what I see after any major event like this, is helping your neighbors. We always see people helping people, neighbors helping neighbors. Incredibly important, especially if you know of somebody who has not experienced a storm like this before. Helping them understand what it is they need to do, checking in on your neighbors that might need some special assistance after the storm passes. Really, our neighbors, they are our first responders, and the work that they do after a storm passes really helps the first responders do their jobs more quickly and more efficiently. So I'll just repeat really quick on some of the steps that you can do. Make sure you're signing up for local emergency alerts, making sure you're identifying local shelters if you need to go to one, know what your evacuation plan is, check on your neighbors, and encourage all of your loved ones to do the same. I think if you've heard me say before, and I'll just say it again, we are ready, FEMA is ready to support Governor DeSantis and his state's efforts to respond to this incident. We will be here through the response and any recovery that's needed. Thank you very much.